I had another question on, it kind of came up earlier, when I've had a very full of step one relationship with a roommate, and people say, oh, well, that's their stuff, but if it's in my experience, I'm matching it with my vibration. So
it's never
reconcile that. Like,
it's never someone else's stuff, ever.
And so how, like, I'm wanting to clean my stuff up.
You don't have to clean it up.
Just get in the vortex.
Every time you try to clean it, it gets dirtier.
Okay. I would rather have it clean than dirty, so just get in the vortex.
That's the thing that's so tricky. You cannot turn your attention to a problem without shining your attention on it, activating the vibration within you. We started to say earlier, and we didn't follow the sentence through, every thought is already vibrating. And so when you focus upon it, you activate the vibration of it within you. And that active vibration, if you stay focused there for as little as 17 seconds, becomes a point of attraction that begins to expand. 17 seconds on a subject brings enough other like it to it that now you're invested to some momentum. So when you give your attention to something and it activates within you, we would call it simply an activated thought. And it's important to know, because for every activated thought, there's an in the vortex activated thought to which you are feeling a relationship. Now, you can activate a thought for as little as 17 seconds. This is new. We've not said this before. You can activate a thought for as little as 17 seconds, and the relationship between that thought and the thought within you, the thought in your vortex, your inner being's thought, up to 16 seconds, there is no real awareness of the relationship between those two thoughts. You've got 16 seconds of leeway. But if you cross the 17 second mark, now you've activated a point of attraction, and now the relationship between the thought you're thinking and the thought that your inner being is thinking on the same subject are giving you an emotional response. Now, depending on how sensitive you are to your emotions, you might pick it up right there. Esther, Jerry, many of you, pick it up right there. And Esther will say, I don't have to think about that right now. But if you think that thought longer, now we'll carry out the other thought first, and then we'll come back and wrap it into that. So a thought that you're briefly thinking is activated. If you hold it for more than 17 seconds, now it's more activated, and now more thoughts like it will be there. And now it's a more compelling or attractive thought to you. It's something that now you're feeling a little bit of interest in. If you go there and focus 17 seconds, until you reach that 68 second mark, that's the real magic vibrational activating number, because at 68 seconds, that activation within you becomes a true vibrational force to deal with. In other words, now you've got a thought that's so active that we would call it a belief. Now, hear this, that surprises you, because you'd think, oh, 68 seconds is all it takes to believe something. The thing is, we love you very much. You always know something's coming when we say that to you. The thing about it is, most of you don't think your negative thoughts any more consistently than you think your positive thoughts. You're sort of fickle about what you're thinking. So it takes some real drum beating or a real partner who is holding your attention negatively. In other words, it takes quite a bit for those beliefs to form, just like it takes a little bit of work for you to get into the vortex. So let's just leave it simply this. Thoughts that you think, they're just thoughts. Thoughts you keep thinking become chronically thought, easier to think. Those are what beliefs are. Those represent your expectation. And once you've reached expectation, and it's easy to do, you offered a vibration and you did it long enough that it started showing up in your experience, and now you've got proof. So now you know, just believe it, you know it. You expect it. You expect it to be the way that it is. And we want to say to you, you've created it to be. In other words, the word expectation sounds like something out of your control has created it, and now you just have to expect it to be because that's just the way it is. Well, nothing is just the way it is. Everything is the way it is because someone expected it into being, you see. So here you are, you have this magnificent platform, and lots of things that you've expected to be are serving you extremely well. So we're just encouraging you to pick and choose among the things that you're expecting and start deliberately expecting the things that you want to be. And that's where people who aren't up to speed with what we're teaching, who don't know about vibration, who don't know about the vortex, who don't know about emotions, who don't know about the two vibrational aspects of them which give them the reason for emotions, people who don't understand that call it delusional for you to not face reality and to deliberately think about something that is separate from reality. But that's because they don't understand deliberate creating at all. Most everybody you meet are creating by default. They're just looking at whatever is easily seeable, letting it train their vibration to it, then therefore creating more of it and calling it just the way that it is. Well, you all know too much. There should have been something on the disclaimer that you signed when you came in indicating that you can't go back. Because once you know this, once you know about the vortex, once you know about the larger vibrating aspect of you, now your emotions are really meaningful. And now, of course, there are things that you think because you've been thinking them, because it's easy to expect them, because that's the way this person is. This person is just that way, and it's hard for me to expect otherwise. And we say, might be hard, but it's not impossible. And if you will say to yourself, I'm going to train my expectation to satisfy the good feeling I'm reaching for, rather than trying to satisfy some testimony of truth. Esther, even in the beginning, she would say to us, but Abraham, but it's true. But it's true. Like, shouldn't that give me a pass? Isn't it okay for me to think about it if it's true? And we say, that doesn't count for anything. There are all kinds of things that are true that you don't want to recreate in your experience. That's a terrible reason to give your attention to something.
You train your expectation by feeling how it feels to be over there. Is that how you train your expectation when you don't have physical proof of it in whatever instance you're focusing?
You train your expectation by your attention to a subject. In other words, it's just by practicing it. You can train your expectation anywhere, just by attention to it. Because if you think it, somebody could tell you a complete lie. They could even make a national holiday out of it. And as you give your attention to it long enough, other things, someone could have a very strong conspiracy theory that's not based in reality either. And they could speak it enough that people could give their attention to it. That's the thing that's so interesting about letting those outside of you be the reason for your attention to things, is that on either side, they're sure they've got the truth. And in no case does it have anything to do with you. Because as you've lived your life, you've created your vortex version, which is the only thing you've got to live up to. And if you don't, you won't feel good. So bring us back around to the question that you just posed. Can you remember it?
How do you expect a positive outcome or steps toward your vortex when you've been focusing on a subject that's the opposite end of the stick of that, so you haven't had the experience of having it work out for you?
You can't. It's impossible.
So then you just shift your focus to something else and get in the vortex?
In the way that you set that question up, if what I expect is what's happening, right, and what's happening is what I expect, how can I shift my vibration or my attention?
We say, I know you can't.
You can't, because yeah. So what you have to do is introduce into the mix a very important factor, which is, how do I want to feel?
Okay, I can definitely do
that. And this thought feels awful, and this thought feels better, and this thought feels great. So now I'm choosing not based upon what I formerly called fact. I'm choosing based upon what I call the way I feel. Mm-hmm. I'm choosing based upon what I now know to be my inner being's point of view. Mm-hmm. You could take a subject, any subject, such as worrying about your children or worrying about your grandchildren or worrying about the world's children or worrying about the beasts of your planet. You could take any subject and focus on it just for a little while and bring yourself right out of the vortex. But there's a very important piece of information that we want to insert here into this dialogue at this point, because you haven't thought about this before. And when you do, you will be forever changed. The spectrum of life experience is huge. There are people living such amazing lives of luxury or joy, or but let's put it in the realm of just living life experience. There are people living in comfort that is nearly indescribable, and there are people who are living in discomfort that is nearly indescribable. And the spectrum of life experience is huge, vast, vast, vast difference in the spectrum. But the emotional range is not vast. The range between joy and powerlessness is not vast. It's manageable. Esther said one day when she watched something on television of a terrible plight on a lot of people, and as Esther watched it, it brought her to her knees. She could not stand and see it. It was too awful. And she said, "Abraham, if it feels that awful to me to watch that from this distant vantage point of supreme comfort, what must it feel like to those people who are living it?" And we said to Esther, "They're not taking it as hard as you are." Because it's not about the spectrum of experience. It's the spectrum. In other words, you come as energy beings, and you can't get that far away from who you really are. This is our way of saying, no matter where you are in terms of bodily conditions, in terms of financial conditions, in terms of relationship, no matter where you are in terms of anything, you're not that far from the vortex. You're not that far, you see. And if you listen closely, knowing what you're hearing here, to those people who are speaking their success stories, you know that's true. One day they had nothing, and the next day they were discovered. You see, and how did they, and you think, oh, it's some lucky break. And we say it was vibrational movement that allowed, and in the vortex rendezvous that led to that, you see. So that's why we get a little animated when we talk to you about this vortex that you can't see. If we can convince you that there is a vibrational relationship that you have the ability to manage, and we can distract you from all those impossible or unmanageable or uncontrollable things that you think you've got to control before you feel better, and we can show you that you can feel better now just because you want to, you'll return to your power. You'll return to the leverage of inside the vortex, and things will shift for you, and they'll shift for you fast. Yes.
Thank you. I love
and
you.
You did win the lottery.
I know I did. I know. But it doesn't even matter now. I don't even feel like it matters anymore. And I was so tied into
understanding
that
of the vortex and deliberate application and managing of your emotions will give you success no matter what the subject of your interest, no exception.
Thank you. I love you so much.